Hey guys, so today I am so excited for this video. I am gonna be showing you guys today the three new like collections-ish of the new Nabla Cutie Palette collection. That is the worst way to describe that. So Nabla has these palettes called their Cutie Palettes. And these are the two that they've already come out with previously. This is the nude one, and then this is the coral one. And I have already used these. I used this on my channel before, and I have used this one before as well, just kind of like on myself. So they already have those, and they basically extended the line of their cutie palettes. So they came out with three new cutie palettes, and then three new lipsticks called the Glam Touch lipsticks. Then one each goes with like each palette, as well as these Cupid's Arrow things, which are basically like, they seem like kind of like casual pencils, you know, where they're kind of like a thicker kind of eyeliner that you can use as a liner, or you can smudge it out and use it as like an eyeshadow base, kind of like multi-use on the eyes. Again, in three different colors, kind of like for each palette. So that's what I'm gonna be showing you today. I'm gonna show you a different look with each palette. So I did three different looks using each palette, and then each different eyeliner and each different lip as well. So yeah, that's kind of it. I'm going to kind of deviate from how I usually do my videos, and I'm going to start off first with kind of like my review and showing you the palettes and reviewing them first, and then I will do the actual like makeup looks and tutorials at the end, which is kind of different than I usually do. But yeah, I just kind of wanted to go ahead and like start talking about them because I'm really excited about them. So they came in a beautiful box. Each has their own look. So this is the Platinum palette. That is what the palette looks like. You've got like some really nice browns in there, and then you have like two bronzes, and then a darker gray and a light, really light bright silver kind of color. And that is the palette. And then of course you get a lipstick. This is sort of like a mid-tone kind of like brownie nude. And then you get the eyeliner, which I was very intrigued when I first saw this eyeliner, because I was like, God, that's kind of really light for an eyeliner. And it's not a nude, like a light nude. So I already kind of have swatches on my hand because I love playing with makeup. You guys know this. But it's sort of like this eyeliner is like a medium brown, which I think is kind of like an interesting concept because I don't think companies usually come out with colors like that. So I kind of like that. It was really different. So that is the Platinum ones. And then for the next one, this is called Metropolitan. And this is the palette on the Metropolitan one. So that's what it looks like. So you're gonna get a deep brown. You've got a pretty bright pink over here. This is a duochrome white. So it looks white, but it's kind of like a duochrome pink. And then you get a really beautiful, like bright bronze. And then this stunning, stunning mid-tone brown shimmer. This color is beautiful. So that is the second palette. And then this one, the coordinating liner is a dark, dark brown. And then this lipstick is like a lighter brownish nude shade. So that is the Metropolitan set. Now I don't believe these come like in a set. I believe they're like all separate. I'll make sure to put like the pricing here so you can see how much like each individual thing is. I know the palettes are $24, I believe. I can't remember these off the top of my head. I think it's like 16 for this and then somewhere around the same for this. But yeah, that is the Metropolitan one. And then finally you have Wild Berry. So here we are with Wild Berry. I love the artwork on these palettes. That's one thing about Nabla palettes that I'm pretty sure I've talked about before. The palettes are weighted really nice. They're very thick. They're cardboard, but like the most high quality cardboard, if there was such a thing. Very thick, like a magnetic closure. So they feel very securely closed. And then you do get a mirror in them as well, which is nice. And I love the artwork, like attention to detail out of this world for these palettes. But here's the Wild Berry palette. Stunning, so stunning. So with this one, you get like a nice, really deep plum shade. You've got a, like a brighter pinky, like magenta. You've got this one, which is more of like a pinky red, and it's kind of slightly like muted. So it's kind of slightly like a muted, I don't know, something to it, so it's not too bright. And then this one is like a satin, very peachy brown. It looks like it's gonna be kind of brownish, but when you actually swatch it and like put it on your hand, it is more peach, less brown. and the satiness is very subtle. So I could see myself definitely using this as like a crease color. And then you've got this color here, which is sort of a duochrome, and it shifts between a more like orangey red and being having a pink shift. So it's kind of like definitely a peach undertone. And again, with that like shifting glitter between pink and orangey. And then you have this shade here. They actually call this Alchemy 2. It's like a very light base. I can't even tell what the base color would be. Maybe like a light beigey kind of base color, but then it's got purple and teal shift to it. And I actually have, they have a single shadow, which I have here. Get out of this palette. This is the original Alchemy. And it's kind of got that same thing where it's got that duochrome, like purple to blue shift, but it's like darker. So this is sort of like the lighter cousin. They're like cousins, I would say, to the original Alchemy. I know that Alchemy shadow is really popular from them. So yeah, this is called Alchemy 2. And then the pencil that coordinates with this palette is a really deep maroon, kind of aubergine, you know, plum color. And then the lipstick is also a plum color, but again, it's kind of like muted. That's what I'm wearing now. This is the palette and the liner I have on right now. And yeah, it's kind of like, it's a plum, but it's got like this slight kind of like grayed out muted factor to it. So it's not like over the top colorful, if that makes sense. So in terms of quality, this is kind of be kind of short and sweet. The quality in these palettes is the exact same quality that I expect and have experienced with all of Nabla's eyeshadows before. They're amazing. They are, to me, the closest thing to like Natasha Denona level, like very bougie feeling, richly pigmented, creamy, intense eyeshadows that I have in my collection. There is nothing about these shadows that is dry. So something like Morphe or Juvia's Place are some of my also like all-time favorite eyeshadows. They are more on the dry end, but they still work extremely well. But you guys probably know what I'm talking about, and that feeling like when you pack on a color and it feels dry and it seems dry and maybe more likely to get patchy. Those are kind of like how I think of like Juvia's Place or Morphe. Now, I love Juvia's Place and Morphe. I still know how to make those work. I still think they're great quality and they're super pigmented. But these shadows, Nabla's seems like their whole formulation in general is very like creamy. Like, and I talked about this when I did my Metropolis palette review from Natasha Denona, where the matte shadows almost feel wet because they're just like, there's something about them. The Nabla ones feel very similar. You will not, to me, in my opinion, in my experience, find a matte shade from Nabla that like you put it on and it's not like insane, intense, like boom color the first time. And you'll see that in the video when I'm using, especially some of these dark mattes. Dark mattes, especially dark purples like this, can be very like patchy and weird and dry and kind of like go awkward on the eye. But as you can see, does not happen with these shadows. The quality is insane. For that price too, like $24, is such a good price for the quality you're getting in these. Like, you would not be disappointed. So if you like color stories, you'll really like these. They have weird color stories though. So maybe you wouldn't think, like this one's actually pretty good. I would say like Metropolis is definitely a one where you're kind of like, what? Like, it's kind of weird. I mean, I felt the same way when I first looked at it. But that's kind of how I feel, and I mentioned this before about Juvia's Place too. I feel like now I kind of like weird color stories because they make me try things that I might not usually try. I am a creature of habit, and I will do the same kind of eye look and put the same kind of colors together. So when I was forced today, the first time I used this palette, to put like this pink with this brown and all these other colors, and I think I used all the colors except for the gold, I used all the other colors, to force me to put those kind of colors together, it makes me try different things that I don't normally try. And that's something I really like about Nabla. I've said it before, like I just said, it's something I like about Juvia's Place. There's only a couple brands I found really that really kind of make you go out of your box with the colors they put together, because you wouldn't necessarily think it goes together, but then it does and it looks really nice. So I love that. The only shadow color I had trouble with was this one right here, Venom. And it's not that I had trouble necessarily with the pigmentation because it went on really nice, but I will show you, and you guys know I hate this so much, but when you kind of press into this one, it does get very powdery, this shade. I didn't have any trouble with any of the other shades doing that. It was just that one in particular. So be forewarned. I personally hate that because I feel like I'm wasting product and I don't want to be wasting product. I mean, I obviously have a million fucking eyeshadow palettes. So, I mean, wasting a little bit of eyeshadow in one is probably not an issue, but say for someone who maybe doesn't have a million eyeshadow palettes and they want to buy one of these palettes and they want it to last forever, you might be disappointed if, you know, after you use that purple one, you know, 10 times, you already have a dip in it because half of it's been wasted from just like flying everywhere. So it's just something I like to point out because I hate that. In terms of the liner pencils, they worked very well. They're very pigmented. They went on really nice. I did, and you'll see in the video, I used before each shadow look my P. Louise blank canvas base. So keep in mind that each of those colors was mixing with the really light nude base. So if you use them on their own, they probably come up a bit darker because they're not having to compete with mixing with this. But I just like, you know, this is kind of like, I'm doing this how I would normally do my makeup. So I would always put this down or any kind of base down, like concealer or something. So again, if you want them to be like even darker, you could probably not use a lighter base down first. But in terms of how they blended very easily. They were creamy. Obviously with these kind of pencils, they can get dull really easy because they're like chunkier, but there is on the bottom a sharpener. So if you ever needed to like sharpen it to make the point a little more pointy, you could do that. And then in the lipstick formula, this is my kind of formula. If you guys have been following me long enough, you know, MAC Amplified lipstick formula is my favorite kind of lipstick formula. I like creamy lipsticks. I will do like matte lipsticks in the Bullet if I have to because it's like a nice color and if it works well. But if I had to like choose a lipstick to wear, it would be this kind of lipstick that is very, very creamy. I like a creamy, hydrating, moisturizing lipstick that has a lot of color. And so that's why I've always liked the MAC Amplified lipsticks. And these are very similar. So they're kind of gonna give you that like creamy, velvety feel. They feel very hydrating, but they are also like full coverage color. So the color is gonna come off really strong. Even though they are kind of slippery in a way, in like a very good way. So yeah, I like it all. It's very good. I was not surprised. Nabla has been a brand that like, ever since they like sent me that like first package and I was able to try everything, they definitely had like hits and misses. But I think they're so popular in Italy and they're getting so popular in the US for a very good reason that the quality is very, very good. So you will not be disappointed in any quality issues or anything like that. So it's really gonna be based on if you like the color story. One color I really wanna point out is in the Platinum palette, this color right here. Also this color right here I really liked, which you'll see in the video, but this silver is crazy. If you want a wild, bright, intense silver, that is it. And then another thing to note is most of the shimmers in these palettes are gonna be intense shimmers. These are not like basic, soft, cute, basic shimmers, you know? They are gonna be, they're all very glittery shimmers, which is like my personal kind of favorite. So each of the shimmers has like a metallic base with a lot of glitter in them. Some will be more than others, but most of them are gonna be, like I said, a shimmery base with a ton of glitter. And as you can see, they're very foiled. So if you're someone who likes foiled, kind of very intense metallics, you'll like these a lot for that reason. So if there's a particular one that you find that you're like, oh, I like that color story, and you want that like foiled shimmer, you'll like them a lot. I would say out of all of them, my favorite palette is this one for the color story. The quality is pretty much the same all the way across each of them. But in terms of color story, I love this one the most. I've been kind of trying to get back into like shimmer, like not shimmer, like cool tones. I like that one a lot. And then my second favorite would definitely be Berry. And my third favorite would be the Metropolitan one. Just because the color story is a little bit harder. Like I said, I made it work and it made me go out of my comfort zone. But it's just a little more challenging. However, this shade in here called Dissolution in the... I'm like flipping you guys off, sorry. And the Metropolitan palette, it's like this really beautiful mid-tone brown with like silver shimmer in it. Oh my God. You'll see when in the tutorial when I put that on, I kind of like was very shook because it's very intense. But I'm still brilliant because this video is gonna be literally like 40 minutes long, I feel like at this point. And that is my review. And if you wanna see each of the different looks and tutorials and how I did each look, then just keep on watching. All right, so we're starting off with the Platinum Collection. This part I filmed in the morning, then I got a headache, so I had to stop. So the last two videos, the lighting may look a little different, just an FYI. So I am starting off with the lighter of the two matte shades. It does come off, as you can see, a little darker than it seems in the palette, but I put that all over the crease. And then I took the deeper of the two matte shades, and I'm going to stick that in my outer corner and make like a nice, like thick winged shape. For all these looks, I'm also using my Peaches and Cream glitter base, as I always do in all my videos, you guys know that. Putting a little light layer of that on my lid, and then I'm going in with my lid shimmers. I'm using three, so I'm starting here with Rich Darling, which is so beautiful. I then put Gem System right next to that one, and then finally I took Luxuriance, which is the beautiful bright silver, and I placed that on my inner corner, all the way on my inner corner, and then up a little bit into my crease. I took the same Cupid Zero pencil on the lower lash line. I also did this on the top lash line, but my camera cut out, so it didn't show that part. And then I'm taking the dark matte first, then the lighter matte on the lower lash line, blending those into each other, and also putting those on my waterline. And then I'm going to take those same three shimmers in the same order they are on the top and put them on the bottom of my lower lash line in the inner corner. And you guys know I do this a lot, so just kind of blending them all into each other. I'm then putting on my Nabla Major Pleasure Mascara, which I used in all these looks. And then I'm taking the lipstick from the collection, which is also called Platinum, and applying that. And then after I get that applied, I'm also gonna take a little bit of MAC Stone Lip Pencil just to kind of gray out the edge, because I felt like that tone would go nice with the eye look. And then that is the completed first look. The next look will be with the Metropolitan Collection. So I primed as usual with the P. Louise blank canvas as I did in all the looks. And with this look, I'm starting off with the pencil again on the top. This is exactly what I did in the other look, but again, my camera cut off for that one. But I just did like a chunky kind of winged liner with the pencil. And then I also put that on my lower lash line and my waterline and tight line. And then I just used a little tiny pencil brush just to buff that in and get that softened out a bit. And then after that, I went into the eyeshadow. So I started off with Lorde, the darkest brown in this palette, and I packed that across the liner. This brown in here, in comparison to the last palette, that dark brown, this one's a lot more warm. The last one was very gray toned. So I put that on and then just slightly buffed it in. And then I'm gonna go in with the shade Nothing Personal, the pink, and I'm gonna use that in my crease first with a small brush to kind of lay it down, and then I'm using a bigger blending brush to blend it in. If you already have the Nabla Cutie palette, the coral one, this shade kind of looks like that one, but this one is a lot more pink. It looks kind of coral in the pan, but it comes off a lot more pink. So I just blended that into the brown, and then I put my base as usual, and now I'm going in with my lid shimmers. Again, I'm going to use three. I'm using Love Resin in the outer corner. I'm then using Dissolution in the center of the lid, which is that amazing, as you can see, beautiful mid-tone brown. And then I did Alaska on the inner corner. I'm then taking my deep brown shade on the lower lash line, but this time I'm gonna take this all the way across the lower lash line. And then I'm just gonna slightly buff it out with that kind of pinky tone. After that, I am going to do kind of like I did in the last look, putting those same three shimmers on the lower lash line and blending them across in the same order I did
on the top lash line, and then put on my mascara, and now we're gonna do our lip. This is the lipstick that comes in the collection, the Metropolitan, and I am applying this all over my lips, and then again, for my lip liner, I'm gonna be using this time ColourPop Oh Snap lip liner. This is a slightly mauvey pink lip liner, so again, it's gonna tie in the undertone with the eyes and really pull the whole look together. All right, we are now on the final look using the Wild Berry collection. So this is the palette. I'm gonna start off this look again. I'm already primed with that P. Louise blank canvas. And now I'm gonna use the Cupid Era number 3 pencil, which is this beautiful plum color. And I am this time making this shape for this eyeshadow more round. So I put this pencil all over the lid and then buffed it in with a little pencil brush around the edges. As you can see, as I blend it, it mixes with the base so it gets a little lighter. If you wanted it darker, as I said at the beginning of the video, don't put a light base down first, but I did that. And then I put it on the lower lash line and tight line as well and buff that out. And now I'm gonna start in with Blackberry, the deepest matte shade in this palette. And I'm putting this in the outer corner. This shade is very, very, very strongly pigmented, which I learned on the first eye. So I went in with a little at a time. And now I'm taking Botanic Juice, which is the more like red kind of tone in the palette, and I blended that on the inner half of my crease. And then I took Venom and I'm blending this on the outer half of my crease just to give a little bit of like difference in dimension. I didn't want just one shade all the way across. And then I took Blackberry again and smudged that on my lower lash line. And then I took Botanic Juice, which is the more ready neutral shade, and used that to buff out the lower lash line. I applied my base as usual, and then I started off by applying the shade Alchemy 2.0 all over the lid and on the inner corner. And then I took a little bit of Bucolic Baby, put that next to it, and made sure they blended nice together. I'm gonna put a little more base on my lower lash line, and I am applying the Alchemy 2 shade on my lower lash line as well. And then this time I put on lashes. These are the Ilore Marquise Luxe Silk Lashes, which are beautiful. We're now going in with the Wild Berry lipstick, putting that all over my lips. This shade is stunning. Love this one. And then with this one, I am also gonna take a lip liner. I'm using the shade Half Red from MAC, which will kind of keep with the whole muted undertone of this lip because it's more of like a muted dark pink. It's gonna keep that vibe of having this lip be like a nice berry, but not too colorful.
All right guys, so that is it. I really hope you enjoyed this video, found it helpful. I do highly recommend these palettes if you have some extra money right now and you're looking for something to get. I do not think you'd be disappointed in them, especially if you find a color story within them that you really like. So thank you so much for watching. Again, I appreciate you so much. Please subscribe if you are new. I'd love to have you, and I will see you on my next video. Bye.